we eyes, I keep my eyes open. If you die, stay strapped before you die smoking. All three eyes, I keep my eyes open. Ain't no competition, no prize toast. All three eyes, I keep my eyes open. If you die, stay strapped before you die smoking. All three eyes, I keep my eyes open. Ain't no competition, no prize toast.
Yo, peace and love, family. This Chief Jamal coming at you, Universe Soul,
Balance.
And today's video, I'm gonna be talking about being comfortable in your own skin, learning to be comfortable with who you are and your own purpose. A lot of times, I did a video, I'm gonna post it on here, I'll repost it here, right? I did it on Facebook, talking about adult peer pressure. A lot of times, adults, people who are supposedly grown, they succumb to peer pressure. Peer pressure is actually more pervasive amongst adults than even teens, because everything, all the marketing is geared towards you to pressure you to do something, even if it's buying something for your kids or to buy something for your wife or your husband. Everything is centered towards to get you to fit into some type of societal norm or some type of societal agenda. There's pressure. You have pressure to be politically correct and not say certain things. There's pressure all around for you to conform to something that you may or may not agree with. So with that, you can easily get lost in yourself. That's why I always suggest that never to do too much social media. Give yourself breaks, because you can get lost in other people's ideas and agendas that are being pushed. But a lot of times, we as people are not comfortable with our own skin, and we project our insecurities by how we talk about or deal with others, or how we try to pair bond with others for our relationships, or how we try to do business with others, or how we just try to simply socialize with others. We wear our insecurities right on our sleeves, and they're ever present. And a lot of times, those people who are in those situations don't even understand that that's what they're doing. People are maybe, you'll see people a lot of times, even in the manosphere, you'll see people come on, whether it be a female or whether it be a beta male or whatever you want to say it may be, or come on comments, and they'll be talking, and a video will be addressed to a certain group of men, but they feel the need to comment and inject their two cents and basically say, well, that's not me, and that's not that, that's not all women, or that's not all men. It goes both ways. Men do it on women videos as well. And then what they're doing, and they're thinking that they're proving the point, or that they're trying to make some type of righteous stance. But really, all they're doing is showing their own insecurity, showing that they're not comfortable with themselves enough to either see something that they disagree with and move forward and ignore it, or to simply just, you know, say I disagree and move on. But instead, they try to force their opinion or view or their conditioning on other people. They don't want to believe that this information being disseminated can be true, or can be possibly something that they fit that's a negative for them, or it's cutting them, or it's a sword cutting them. Even the scripture says that scriptures are the word of truth is a two-edged sword, dividing asunder even the soul from the spirit. So that's not just the Bible, but anything that is truth is cutting to a person. Anything that is truth is not comfortable to someone who's not in truth. So their initial reaction is going to be a go against it or fight it. Now, they don't mean that all the time, that when people have objections to things because it's because it's truth. People can object things that are not true and corrected. But a lot of times they're not doing that. They're just simply displaying their own insecurities. It takes someone special and someone who really wants growth within themselves to say, you know what? Why do I care what these people think? I don't know these people. Why is it bothering me? And not just say why and try to brush it under the rug, but really ask the question why. Why does this bother me that this group of people think this? What is it about me that makes me want to go against this situation without even really having to go again? They're not really even attacking me directly. They're not even really affecting my life. But for some reason, their stance bothers me. Why is that? And taking self-examination. It takes people who really, truly want truth. When you truly want truth, you're understanding that it's going to cut you. It's going to make, you can't make anything of value without it being a refining process. Look how much pressure it takes on coal to make diamonds, or how it has to be cut and made. It takes a lot of pressure and cutting to make diamonds. So if you want to be something of value, a diamond, you have to go through pressure and cutting. That's just part for the course. And in doing that, the first step of that is self-discovery. Understanding who you are. What do you really like? A lot of you guys go into these YouTube videos or into these so-called self-help videos, or you're trying to get your dating game up or whatever it may be, and you are listening to that creator's idea of what they like. And because that's a popular creator, you're conforming to what that creator likes, not even realizing it. You're succumbing to adult peer pressure. You're not allowing yourself to be who you actually are. You might not mind dealing with a woman who's a single mother, depending on the circumstances, but you'll see a bunch of people going against that, talking against that, and you'll try to conform to something that you really don't, that really doesn't fit you. That may be for them. Or women in a certain age range, or men in a certain age range. For women, you'll see that, oh, you need to get a man with six figures and this, and you really in your heart don't care about that, but because you see people that you so-called admire care about that, you feel the need to try to conform to that. And that is wrong. And that is a recipe for disaster, because you're not only going to probably not accomplish that because it's not for you, you're going to miss your own destiny and purpose. Never be the person who's chasing another person's dream, destiny, and purpose. I'll repeat that again. Never be the person that's chasing another person's destiny, dream, and purpose. Without self-knowledge and self-worth, that's what you will be doing. You'll be building another man's or a woman's castle. Build your own. Have a ruling mentality. When you have a ruling mentality, see, balance brings, and I did the video about the purple pill, about how that is really about royalty, not what they're telling you about. Balance brings royalty. Royalty, you don't have, if you're just the king or queen of yourself, you are royal, because you have rulership over your appetite, over your diet, over your spirituality, over your moral system, over your sexual system. That makes you a king or a queen within yourself. At the end of the day, that's all that matters. Because if you do that, others who are like-minded and are in a rulership mindset will attract to you. But if you don't do that first, you'll be forever chasing something and seeking some type of validation or appropriation for who you are, instead of being comfortable with who you are. Whatever you like is what you like. You don't have to explain it to someone. You don't have to apologize for what you like and what you want to be. So remember that, family. Be comfortable in your own skin. Be comfortable. Be content with who you are. Be content with being royal within yourself. It don't have to be, it's not, you don't have to worry about the validation of others. That will come with your own expectations being met. Trust me. So with that being said, I'm gonna sign out. Just a quick video for y'all right here on the boardwalk, Atlantic City, doing the thing. We'll touch back with y'all, family. Peace and love.
Who bless the wicked, according to their deeds, bless the righteous man hand to make the bitches please, bless the righteous in their seeds to grow and to achieve, but without a sign, how the fuck they gon' believe? Lord bless the wicked, according to their deeds, bless the righteous man hand to make the bitches please, bless the righteous in their seeds to grow and to achieve, but without a sign, how the fuck they gon' believe? Every little step I take, yeah, you know.